In this video, I explain you steam or evaporative cooling system for a IC engine. First, we understand the meaning of evaporative. Evaporative means it is the one process in which liquid is converted into a vapor phase. Okay, and here we also written it is a steam. Means in this cooling system, water is used and in a water jacket, the water is converted into the steam. That's why its system is known as the steam cooling or evaporative cooling. Okay, so generally in a thermosiphon and a thermostat cooling system, it is only sensible heat transfer is takes place. Means phase of the water is not changed in that system. But in this system, the water state is changed. Okay, means evaporate. It is changed, water is converted into a steam. Okay, that means it is a latent heat transfer is takes place. And when the latent heat transfer is takes place, more amount of the heat is transferred from an engine to the atmosphere. The steam cooling system is also known as vapor phase system because in the flow of part, water is converted into a steam. Okay, so water is converted into a steam, that's why it is known as the vapor phase system. Hence, in this system, high cylinder jacket temperature are used. So, temperature is higher in the water jacket. The advantage of high latent heat of water is taken by allowing it to evaporate in engine cylinders or in a separate flash tank. Means water is evaporate either in the water jacket or either in a separate flash tank. So here you see, this is the diesel engine in which we supplied the cold water by using the pump. Then this water, cold water, is going inside the water jacket. Then its temperature is heated. And this hot water is coming or either a steam is coming, okay, depending on this condition, whatever is written in the last step. Then after this, hot water is supplied to a flash tank, okay. So here the flash tank. Flash tank is a device which the direct heat transfer is takes place. Means cold water is come directly in a flash tank, okay. So steam is take the in upper positions, in upper part of the flash tank, and water is collected in the lower parts because the steam density is lower, so steam is moving in upper part. And this flash tank is mount on a one support. So now steam coming out from the flash tank is supplied to the condensers. Condenser is the one type of heat exchangers. The meaning of condenser is to this steam is condensed, means condensation process is going on. That's why the name is condensers. Okay, otherwise it is one type of the heat exchangers. So these, for the removing the heat from these steams, we are required some another medium. Okay, so for another medium we are using the air. And if the air is passing naturally, then it is natural circulations, but here we putting the one fan. Okay, so this fan is circulate the air, that's why it is a forced circulation of the air which takes place from the condenser. So steam is passing inside this tube, and outside the tube the air is passed. So atmosphere air is absorbed the heat from the steam. So this steam is converted into a water, and this outlet of the water is supplied to this pump, and its temperature is reduced, that's why it is the cold water. And this cold water is again supplied into the flash tank, and in a flash tank this cold water and this hot water coming, it's directly mix. Okay, so its temperature is reduced and the stream of the water is converted into the steam, and this water from the flash tank is supplied to the engines by using this pump and the cold waters. That's where the cycle is continuously run. So it consists of the two pump. Okay, so here in this image you see, this is the two pump, this one and this is the second one. Okay, so consists of the two pump, one for water circulation in the jacket. So this pump is circulate water to the jacket, and another for the condenser and the flash tank, or it is also known as the overhead tank as shown in the figure. Before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe the channels if you not subscribes, and visit the playlist for watching the more video related to mechanical engineering. And you also go for the top right screen of your mobiles or laptop where the I symbol is there, from where you have watched the more video related to IC engine. The pump supplied the water to the cylinder jacket with high flow rate, hence it prevents steam formation in the cylinder jacket when the water absorb the heat from the cylinders. Okay, So this pump supplied the water to the water jacket. At that time they absorbed the heat from the engine cylinders. In that, there is a high mass of the water is supplied through this pump. So this high mass of the water is prevent the steam formation in the cylinder jacket when the water absorbs the heat from the cylinder. The cylinder jacket temperature is quite high, so that a part of water change into a low pressure steam when it reaches to a flash tank. Okay, so the water jacket temperature is higher, so some part of the water, means some part of this cold water, is converted into a low pressure steam when it reach to a flash tank. The heat required to make a steam is taken from remaining water to flash tank. Therefore, this water is cooled and then recirculated through the cylinder jacket. Means this water is absorbed the some heat from the waters, so it is converted into the steams, and this water is supplied to this cold water. The steam leaving the flash tank is condensed in a condenser. What is the meaning of condense? The vapor is converted into a liquid. So here it is a steam, it is converted into the water, that is known as the condensation, and it is occur in a heat exchangers, and this heat exchanger is known as the condenser by help of the water or air. So here we putting the fan, so it's by using the air. So instance of the air, we are also able to use the cold water to cooling the steam coming out from the flash tank. So it is known as the air cooled and water cooled. So here we use the condenser, it is the air cooled. Remains within the system so that no makeup water is needed. So it is a condenser is totally closed. So that's why we not need the makeup water adding in this system. So we not add the makeup water, then no scale formations and no corrosion problem. No corrosion problem in this system. The main advantage of these systems are the temperature in the engine jackets remains almost constant. Okay, so temperature is remains constant, that means uniform cooling is done inside the engine regardless of load. Means if the load is changed, increase or decrease, but the cooling is remains constant and without mechanical control. As the load is increased, more steam is generated, and if the load is increased, then the less steam is generated. So that for no any mechanism is required for controlling the mass flow rate of the water. Also, due to utilization of latent heat of evaporation, this system is require only 40% of water that of the water cooling systems. Means compared to another water cooling system, this system is require only 40% of the water. Means suppose in another system 100 liter of water is required. So in this cooling system, it is only required of 40. Why? Because it's transferred the latent heat. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels, comment on the video, and share with your friend.